This is my interview of last week with the diplomat on the continuing discussion of Xi Jinping's ending the president's term limits, https://thatdiplomat.com/2018/03/Jerome-Cohen-Xi-and-CCP-Aim-for-Unchallenged-Power/Too-Much-Is-Given-Much-Will-Be-Required. By Maurits Ellen Marcos 7, 2018 The Chinese Communist Party, CCP, has contributed much to the success of the modern Chinese nation. A gradual liberalization strategy of the economy has produced widespread growth and raised the standard of living for millions of people. If China continues its current trajectory, it will be crowned the world's largest economy not long from now. No one would disagree, however, that China has also become an increasingly oppressive society, with an ever more authoritarian government suppressing the freedoms of its 1.4 billion citizens in order to meet policy objectives. The trend does not seem likely to be reversed anytime soon. In this interview, Jerome Cohen, a professor of law at New York University and lifelong friend of China, shares his views on the National People's Congress's upcoming decision to remove the presidential term limit from the Chinese constitution. Maurits Ellen, or peaceful power transitions in China, as seen since Deng Xiaoping, now less likely to occur without clear succession mechanisms in place. Jerome Cohen, as many observers agree, ending the term limit is a recipe for increasing political instability and weakening, and perhaps even ultimately dividing the party. With no designated successor, serious illness or death of the leader could lead to chaos long before the end of the second term, not to mention beyond that. There are Western leaders who have served a prolonged time in office, sometimes more than a decade. How does this compare to Xi? Long leadership in a democratic country places the leader and his party in an entirely different position. As the British public demonstrated after World War II when it repudiated the great Churchill after he led the country to victory, even the greatest leader can be replaced in a democracy. And remember, the British decided to bring Winston back after they got a dose of Clement Attlee. It was all very orderly, even despite the fact that the UK was in a bad domestic shape and was losing its international power at the time. Click here to continue reading this interview.